So these are all Bahama lures. They're made in North Carolina. They all feature keel weights, which is unusual for lures, and that means that there's only weight in the lower half of the head. And this will produce a very stable lure that will run upright. It won't roll over. Bait fish don't roll over, so the lures don't want to roll over. This also allows you to set the hook in any position that you want. You might want the hook down, you might want the hook up. If it's on the outriggers, you might want to have the hook to the side so the fish comes in, meets the hook. You might want to put the hook the other way around for the outrigger on the other side of the boat so the fish meets the hook. If the fish comes in and doesn't meet the hook, he's not going to get caught. So the keel weight can be used not only to stop the lure from rolling over, but to arrange the hook where you're going to want it. Another feature of these lures is what we call the fluoro lures. These are all highly fluorescent. The eye, the head, the skirts, everything. So on an overcast day, such as today, you're going to have a much brighter lure in the water. This is going to stand out great against a dark, dark blue background, and the fish is going to be able to see it. This is one of the reasons that pink is such a very, very good fish color. There's no bait fish that's pink, but a lot of fish are caught on pink lures. And this is the reason. It's just easy to see. The fish can key in on it and grab it without any trouble at all. Another substance I'm working on is gold, which for bright days is just phenomenal. They'll see the reflection a long way away from the lure and just come in on that. So we got gold, we've got fluorescent, and we've got bait fish colors, a dark on top and a white belly. The hook rigs, they're all set for each different size of lure. When the lure is done, the hook wants to be at the back, not quite inside the skirt. This would be too short because the skirts will bunch up and cross over and get in a mess. It wants to sit about there. That way the lure will swim, the hook won't get tangled up, everything will be fine. So we got different size hook sets for different size lures. That's going to have to be shortened so we can cut them off to fit. The back of the lure head has a stopper. This is what we call the hook lock. Pull the leader through, and then the top crimp jams up in there, and this is how we set the hook. So if we want the hook down, we turn it so that the hook is down. If you want the hook up, we can turn it so that the hook is up. This only works with a keel-weighted lure. If the lure isn't stable, you don't know where that lure is, then you don't know where the hook is. This is our main teaser. It's called the Neptune. It's a double-jointed teaser. It goes through the water like a little tuna clacking. This is also a good way to demonstrate the keel weight, where the head is keel weighted. It will always return upright. It won't roll over. Same with the tail. It's harder to demonstrate that though. But this is a good demonstration for the keel weight. Down here we got some smaller lures. White marlin, tuna, dolphin, mahi-mahi. And some even smaller ones for the real finicky fish, just the size of your hand. I love fishing. I love the lures. There's nothing like a marlin crashing a lure in the back of the boat. It's exciting. It's great. And it's great to get lures out to guys and have them have a good time catching fish. And they're always coming back. And that's a good feeling. It's almost better than doing it yourself, actually. When someone else comes with a story about how they won a tournament or caught a fish on one of your lures, it's a wonderful feeling.